Asato ma satnamaya, namaso ma jyotirnamaya, nityorma amritam namaya.
Hello everyone, this is Mahendra. In this video, we are going to solve exercise 4.2, problem number 1. Look at the question. Now, this is a given question. In the given figure, this is the figure given. Three lines, AB bar, CD bar, EF bar, intersecting at O. Find the values of X, Y, Z. It is being given that X is to Y is to Z, that is equals to 2 is to 3 is to 5. Okay. So given, this is the figure. So AB and CD, EF are three straight lines intersecting at a point O. This is the point of intersecting here, right? So what we have to find, and given the ratio X is to Y is to Z, these are the angles. X is to Y is to Z is the, these are the angles. Given the ratio 2 is to 3 is to 5. Okay, so obviously, so X is to Y is to Z is equals to 2 is to 3 is to 5. So how many parts? Yeah, total parts is 10 parts, isn't it? So the larger ratio, the bigger ratio contains bigger angle. Okay, next, Y is the bigger angle, then next, X is the smaller than X and, sorry, Y and Z. Okay, right? So this is Z, writing in a different manner here. Yeah, right, Z it is, right? So solution, right? So given AB bar and CD bar and EF bar are the three lines. Okay, right? So if you observe this figure, you may get the idea here. What is the angle of this? What is the angle here? I'm writing with a blue pen here. What is the angle here? You get an idea? Yeah. These two angles are vertically opposite angles because they are not having any common arm and they are not adjacent angles. That is why these two, this one and this one, both are vertically opposite angles. So vertically opposite angles, vertically opposite angles are equal. We have seen this in the previous video. Okay, right? So this is X degrees. Similarly, this is Z degrees. This is Y degrees. Okay, all are vertically opposite angles. Okay, right? Given angles X, Y, Z in the ratio X is to Y is to Z is equals to 2 is to 3 is to 5. Okay, right? So from the figure, we can say one more thing. The sum of all these angles, that is nothing but X degrees. Yeah, I'm starting from here. X degrees plus Z degrees plus Y degrees plus X degrees plus again Z degrees plus Y degrees is equals to how much? It is a complete one rotation, isn't it? It is a complete one rotation. So what is a complete one rotation? It is nothing but a complete angle. So what is a complete angle? That is nothing but 360 degrees. Already we know that complete angle is equals to 360 degrees. It completes one rotation. If you sum all these angles, it becomes one complete rotation. Okay, that is nothing but, so look at here. Here X is this X, these two X, I'm writing it a same place, and Z plus Z and Y degrees plus Y degrees, that is equals to 360 degrees. What becomes? X plus x, 2x plus this becomes 2y plus 2z is equals to 360 degrees. Is it clear? Right. So I'm erasing this. Yeah. I hope you written. Right. So from this, I'm taking the 2 common. Yeah. I'm adding 2 outside. It becomes x plus y plus z is equals to 360 degrees. Isn't it? So x plus y plus z is equals to this 2 goes to denominator of the 360. Okay. If you want to keep that degree symbol, otherwise your wish. Yeah. 2 ones are 2 ones, 1 remaining, 8, 0. It is 180 degrees. So x plus y plus z is equals to, we got 180 degrees. Okay. So consider it is equation 1. So and we have the ratio x is to y is to z is equals to 2 is to 3 is to 5. So if you sum this, what is that? 3 parts here, 2 plus 3 plus 5 is equals to 10. So what it means? 10 parts. Okay, from the equation 1, from this equation 1, I'm writing here 10 parts is equals to 180 degrees. Okay, 180 degrees. We can calculate this for x degrees. It means 2 parts. How much? Okay, we know that this process we have learned in 8th class. Okay, I'm going to erase. Yeah, how can you find that? Yeah, 2 by 10 into 180 degrees. Okay, this is nothing but 0, 0 gets cancelled. 2 into 18 degrees, this is nothing but 36 degrees. This is becomes belongs to x degrees because I have taken here 2 parts. 2 parts belongs to here. 2 parts belongs to x. Okay, next calculate this for 3 parts. Okay, so that is nothing but 10 parts is equals to 180 degrees. Okay, so 3 parts, how much? What you can write? 3 by 10 into 180 degrees. Okay, 0, 0 gets cancelled. So I will write neatly. Okay, so what becomes? 3 into 18, that is nothing but 54 degrees. This belongs to y because the second one is the part of y. Okay, next. So 10 parts is equals to 180 degrees. Yeah, what about this 5 parts? So 5 parts is equals to how much? So 5 by 10 into 180 degrees. 0, 0 gets cancelled. 5 18s or 18 5s. It is a 90 degrees. Okay, this is nothing but z degrees is equals to 90. Okay, now we got the x, y and z values. Okay, so we shall verify now. So what we have? Equation 1. Yeah, equation 1 is nothing but x plus y plus z is equals to 180 degrees, isn't it? This is equation 1. What is the x value we got? 36 degrees plus y value 54 degrees plus z value 90 degrees, that is equals to 180 degrees. So this becomes 36 plus 54, 19 plus 90, 180 degrees is equals to 180 degrees. Hence our required values x and y and z are obviously true. Okay, so what we can write finally? x is equals to 36 degrees, y is equals to 54 degrees, and z is equals to, we got 90 degrees. Okay, right. So already this is a 90, this is a 54, this is 36. So it is having the vertical approach angles. So these are also same. It becomes completely 360 degrees. Okay, right. This is the solution of the problem number 1 in exercise 4.2.